Here is a randomized trial of radiotherapy versus transoral robotic surgery for oropharyngeal squamous cell carcinoma.
नीरव, नीरव स्क्रीन शेयरिंग में कोई प्रॉब्लम है?
नहीं नहीं सर, और सर ने ऑलरेडी मोबाइल से स्क्रीन शेयर कर लिया ऑलरेडी।
ओके, यू
यस
कैन मेक इट फुल स्क्रीन नाउ।
या ही हैज डन आल्सो फुल स्क्रीन सर। डॉक्टर
बट इट्स
अभिरू
नॉट कमिंग। डॉक्टर अभिरू,
ऑल्सो नोन एज द ऑडिटर ट्रायल। सो दिस पेपर वाज डन बाय डॉक्टर एंथनी निकल्स। So we have seen a gradual rise in the primary surgical treatment of T1 and T2 oropharyngeal squamous cell cancers, while in the year of 2004 it was around 56.2%, but it had increased to 82.1% in the year of 2013. So there has been a lack in the randomized data in this sector comparing primary surgery to the primary radiation for oropharyngeal cancer. So this formed the purpose of the study, which was to compare the following related quality of life at the first year for the patients undergoing primary RT versus primary TORS approach. So this was the ODATER scheme where the T1 and T2 stage patients were randomized into 1:1. In the first arm, they had received concomitant CTRT, and the surgical treatment was kept for the salvage purpose. And in the arm two, the patients were treated by transoral robotic surgery followed by the neck dissection. So these were the main inclusion criteria, which included the squamous cell carcinoma of oropharynx, T stage of T1 and T2, which were likely to have negative margins. And also in the nodal stage, the study had included nodes with no nodes, N1, and also N2. In the radiation arm, the patients having no nodes, they were treated with RT alone with maximum up to 70 gray. And in the node positive patients, CTRT was the choice with preferred high dose of cisplatin. And in the surgery arm, TORS was the primary choice of the surgery, that is the robotic surgery followed by a neck dissection. And adjuvant RT was reserved for the patients having close margin if the lymph nodes were found to be positive. Lymphovascular invasion being positive, and also T3 and T4 disease. And the cytotoxic cisplatin was added in case the margins were found to be positive or extramural extensions. So the primary endpoint was the quality of life assessment at the end of the first year, which was assessed by the MD Anderson dysphagia inventory. And these were the secondary endpoints, which were the overall survival, the progression-free survival, and this EORTC QLQ C30 scales, the patient neurotoxicity questionnaire, the audiology scales, and also the feeding tube rate at the end of the first year. So in today's presentation, we will be basically discussing the MD Anderson scores based on the treatment intensity. In view of the site of the primary tumor, the T1 and T2 diseases, and no nodes plus the nodal diseases. So the primary endpoint was a definitive swallowing related quality of life assessment with the help of the MD Anderson dysphagia inventory score, and there was a 10-point difference, which was specified to be meant as a clinically meaningful change, and 68 patients were randomized into both the arms, and the study was. The study was a two-sided study, which was put under the independent sample t-test with an alpha level of 0.05, and the study was powered to 80% with an assumed dropout rate of 10%. So, for the baseline characteristics, the median age of all the patients were around 58.5. The most important factor here is both the arms had a significant number of P16 positivity rate. Most of the patients in the study were males, and most of them were smokers. We here have most of the primary tumor was located in the tonsil, and there were 44 patients of T1 stage.
Please try to conclude. Please try to conclude. The time is limited.
So what we are getting is that for the primary endpoint in the RT arm, the score is 86.9, and in the surgery arm the score is less. So as far as the scoring is concerned, if the score is more, then we have a better swelling profile. So here we can see that that the swallowing that the patients treated with RT have a lower MDA score. They have less pain, no bleeding or less bleeding, and less amount of trismus. And for the patients receiving surgery, they have less amount of tinnitus and hearing loss, and also less amount of neutropenia. So here in this box and whisker graph, we can see that the median value of the median value of the MDAT score is highest in case of patients receiving RT, and it is lying lowest in the case of surgery followed by RT. This is the difference in the MDAT score in cases of relation to the primary tumor. So here we can see that the base of tongue is basically doing much much better. Here, this is the comparison between the
Dr. Abhiru, please conclude. The chair wants to you should conclude now.
Okay, so though RT has the previous assertions that transoral robotic surgery is basically superior to RT. Appears incorrect, and overall radiotherapy demonstrated statistically significant improvement in the MDAT score, though the specific threshold for a clinically meaningful change was not met. And in the subset analysis today, we can see that RT seems mostly favorable in case of the N plus disease, and also the base of tongue tumors.